views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
Welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio, harnessing our connection with the universe to affect change for optimal success and happiness. Are you looking for direction with your relationships, business, purpose, or simply life? Well, you're at the right place. Named one of the country's top psychics, Eve now brings her insights and gifts to this weekly hit call-in show, joined by visionaries, leaders, gifted others, but mostly you. Get ready for a slice of life's journey, Eve's objective guidance, tarot, readings, and the momentum you need to move beyond whatever crossroad you're stuck at. Now here's your amazing host, Eve.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio, harnessing the power of the universe for happier living. My name is Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. So happy to be here today after a stressful week. Benny, thank you so much for piloting the ship, and many thanks to one and all for tuning in. Originally, I had planned to have on music intuitive Ken Kessler of the Psychic Tapestry podcast today to talk about pendulums. That is going to have to wait until next week, as I got word from him that he's having some phone issues. So I apologize about not being able to talk pendulums today. However, hang tight as we will be back next week to do the show that was planned for today. So this just means that it's just me today. And I'm here to do readings for you on air all show. Normally, I start readings in the second half, but I'll be starting in just a few minutes. I am doing 3-card tarot card readings for callers today, with the first card representing the current situation, the second card representing something challenging or blocking you, and the third card representing advice. If you're interested in getting a reading, give us a call at 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. If you're feeling stuck in your career, disconnected from your life's purpose, at a crossroads, trying unsuccessfully to bring joyful love into your life, we can look at it all through the lens of the reading. As always, please wait at least 3 weeks between readings if you've had a reading from me already. The reason is that a reading sort of pulls from the universe well, so to speak, and if we go to the well too often, the messages that can come up can be redundant and superfluous. That being said, I always love updates. So if you've been putting some ideas into place based on a reading that I gave you and want to share, please do. So today I'll be using the Rider-Waite tarot card deck, so feel free to follow along if you have a deck, or you can look at the cards online. As each reading is done with a fresh perspective, I really do not look at stock interpretations of a card. I don't know who wrote them. Plus, the interpretations vary from source to source, so I'm more interested in the pictures of the cards when I do a reading. I have a candle lit, which is my signal to open a session, and I'll be pulling cards on the caller's behalf using my left hand, as that's my non-dominant hand. The non-dominant hand is the one that accesses the unconscious. For those tuning into the show for the first time, welcome, welcome, welcome. I named this show Mainstream Metaphysics Radio with a very clear intention. As I see myself a little mainstream, a little bit metaphysical, I wanted to have a show where there was something in every show people could use within their ability and power in concrete terms to affect change for optimal success and happiness. Just a little bit about me. If you're new, I am an intuitive coach and professional tarot card reader who works with clients around the world in helping them tap into their own power to affect change for optimal success and happiness. This is done through using energy effectively, even though some of the things I suggest can seem almost counterintuitive. It's my belief that we are all surrounded by energy, and what can happen is that with career, love, or finding your purpose of passion, we sometimes, even with the best of intent, find ourselves blocked with no movement forward. It feels as if you're pushing against wind, which can be taxing to the body, mind, and spirit. This can lead to frustration, stress, and the feeling of working twice as hard but only getting half as far. My role is not to define your path, but rather help you use energy effectively so now you're moving that energy to your back and working only half as hard but getting twice as far. As a result, there's movement of energy and joy can be embraced all from a place of great strength that you created. I use tarot as the primary medium to connect with intuition. And as I look at tarot as a visual representation of the unconscious, with your unconscious on your side, wanting you to succeed, there's nothing scary that can possibly come up. That being said, there are some scary looking cards, but sometimes those are actually the best cards. Please know that I am not a fortune teller and that my readings are not predictive, as I believe that messes with free will. I can totally understand the desire to know when something will happen. I want to know. I hear you. Yet more frustration can actually happen because the path to lead to the place of joy can seem so challenging to overcome without a path. This can actually yield even more stress and frustration. I call myself the MBA psychic, as in addition to having an MBA, I look at a reading as an intuitive jigsaw puzzle where tools to embrace joy are presented through the intricacies of the cards. In addition, last year I was given the great honor of being named one of the top 50 psychics in the United States in the book Top 50 Psychics by Jennifer Diamond, which was totally awesome. So while I will be doing shorter three-card tarot card readings on air today, if you'd like to schedule a full session with me, you can do so directly on my website, which is www.elitetarot.com or mainstreammetaphysicsradio.com. As I do sessions over phone and Skype, as well as in person, clarity, guidance, and insight, no matter where you are, is just a call or click away. So while waiting for the first reading, I gotta tell you about an experience that a dear friend of mine had last week. I asked her if I could talk about it, and she said, absolutely. So my friend has seen over the years many psychics. She was traveling last week and saw that there was a psychic fair in town. So she and a friend went. She paid up front for a 30-minute reading with a psychic, and this is what happened. She said that it was clear from the very beginning that there was just not a connection, and this was not necessarily the psychic being a good or bad psychic. My friend told me, who knows, maybe she had a headache that day, maybe she just couldn't read my friend, maybe it was just an off day. That being said, she's 5 minutes into her 30-minute reading, and this is just not gelling. So they are now on both sides having to suffer through 25 minutes more of a bad psychic reading. And I mentioned this experience as, let's face it, sometimes we are just not on our game. Who is? Well, maybe Benny is always on his game. I know sometimes I head to yoga class and I'm really ready to go when perhaps due to lack of sleep or whatever, I just struggle to get through a class that should have been easy. In terms of work, there have been times when I've had a migraine or I've been sick, worried about something personal, when I realized that I have a reading scheduled and wondered what to do. Now, every person has a different approach to this. But for me, I will contact my client and just be open and then try to reschedule them. I don't like to do this, so I only do this when it is clear that I don't feel my reading would be of benefit to the other person due to my own temporary issue. While this doesn't happen that often, thankfully, whenever I have come right out and just been open about why I want to reschedule, the client has been appreciative as they don't want a bad reading. I'm sure that they would rather I not be feeling under the weather. However, that thought is second to them wanting a good, accurate reading from me. I think sometimes people feel that they might be looked down upon or people might go elsewhere if they reschedule when they know that the reading would not be their best. However, what's worse? In my friend's case, if the psychic had, after 5 minutes, said, look, I'm just having a bad day, and I don't want to mess up your reading. Let me give you back your money, schedule this for tomorrow, or have you speak to a different psychic. My friend might have been disappointed for a few moments, but then much more appreciative than what did happen, where she had to go through 25 yucky minutes and walk away poorer without any new insight. My friend's situation last week also highlights the need to do your research before getting any type of reading. Sometimes people almost seem embarrassed if they ask me questions about my approach before deciding to get a tarot card reading from me. I try to address as many questions as I can on my website, www.elitetarot.com. However, sometimes people have additional questions and they just want to be sure that I'm the right practitioner for them before they purchase a reading. I always tell them that they are doing the right thing to ask questions and that I would much rather answer their questions only to realize that they're looking for a different type of practitioner than have them do a reading for me, spend the money, only to be disappointed. I always say that a reading is like a tattoo, and the messages will stay with you for quite some time. And so, as the ultimate consumer, you need to know the philosophy and approach of the person you're going to get a tattoo from. You wouldn't think of getting a tattoo from someone without knowing, were they going to be doing this in black and white or color? Is this their first tattoo they've ever done? Do they sterilize their needles? Yet so often we seek out metaphysical guidance without having a clear sense of what the person's approach and philosophy will be. If your foot hurts, you have options. You can see a podiatrist, an orthopedic surgeon, an acupuncturist, a general practitioner, a Reiki practitioner, a massage therapist. You hope that each one of those people would be confident in their approach, but they all have a completely different style, technique, and perhaps even philosophy. You make the decision on what specialist is best for you, and there is no right or wrong. So we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're getting right to readings. If you'd like a tarot card reading, give us a call, 800-930-2819. You are listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
Bree Gibbs is a fourth-generation high priestess with the knowledge to raise your vibration and conscious creation. Offering a wide variety of services from goddess light and shamanic healing seminars to private reading sessions, Bree works with you so you too can stand in your own power. Isn't it about time you took your life into your own hands? For more information about Bree's services and products, visit silvergaia.com. That's silvergaia.com.
Wow. Hey, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. This is Talk Radio to Thrive By. I'm telling you, I got to pinch myself some days because when each of us gets called to do something that we so not thought was in our wheelhouse to do for a purpose that's so much greater than us, we get to show up and shine.
If you would like to show up and shine on the Dr. Pat Show as a co-host or sponsor, send us an email to inspire@thedrpatshow.com.
Awareness is universal. Establishing a living awareness through meditation brings peaceful, healthy, and creative well-being into your everyday life. The practice of living awareness, Spiritfire's own meditation practice, is built on this belief and is designed for every level of practitioner. Each year, Spiritfire hosts living awareness meditation retreats that allow you to explore the practice in depth at our retreat center in beautiful Western Massachusetts. Introduce yourself to meditation and the practice at the Foundation's Retreat. Attend, in silence, a silent meditation retreat focused on mindfulness, presence, and nature. Or be engaged with the meditation sittings themselves at the Deepening Retreat. Start adding to your awareness and attend a meditation retreat designed to cultivate consciousness in your everyday life. For details on attending a Living Awareness Meditation Retreat, visit upcoming events at www.spiritfire.com.
Thrive is what we experience when our mind, body, and soul operate as one. When we thrive, we excel on all levels. Thrive is the mindset that matters. It is essential to our being. Have you ever found yourself looking for the instruction manual on how to thrive? You'll find everything you need to help you feel strong, powerful, and peaceful in your own body. So don't waste any more time. Visit thrivebyjen.com today.
You, yes you, can be the highest version of yourself. Wellness coach and natural beauty expert Dr. Agnes Frankel is on a mission to help you play the game of your life. Win in vibrancy, health, and beauty. Because you deserve it. Dr. Agnes goes beyond the limits in her personal coaching sessions to revolutionize health and wellness. Now is the time to unleash your true power. For more information, visit dragnesfrankel.com.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot, talking energy and doing readings. My guest, Ken Kessler of Psychic Tapestry, was having some phone issues today, so we are rescheduling his show on pendulums for next week. So today, it's just me doing readings all hour. On today's show, I'm doing a 3-card tarot card reading with the first card representing the current situation, second card representing something challenging or blocking you, and the third card representing advice. And I always like to start with a little small disclaimer that I am not a doctor, lawyer, therapist, or a realtor, and a reading should never be taken as a substitute for seeking guidance from a licensed professional. So let's just get right to calls. Let's start with Kathy. Kathy, welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
How are you?
I am great. How are you doing today?
Pretty good.
Excellent. Is there anything that you have a question about, would like guidance on, or just a general reading?
I had asked her about my spiritual path, I told her, when she asked me.
All right. Well, let's take a look and see what we got here. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to ask for guidance for Kathy on her spiritual path with a 3-card reading for optimal success and happiness. Just so you know, I'm fanning the cards face down in front of me, and now I'm just choosing whatever card kind of sticks to my finger as I run my left hand over the deck, and then just pulling a card for advice. So let's take a look and see what we got here. Okay, so Kathy, we start with this super neat card, which is the Ace of Cups. And cups are all about the heart, passions, and aces are all about beginnings. So it really talks to this being the start of a new chapter of your journey, one which provides movement and direction, because there, in this card, you see the universe presenting this beautiful cup that's overflowing with water, leading to movement. And there's also a beautiful bird and a little compass kind of saying that hopefully this is going to be providing that direction. Now, I always say that the universe can present opportunities. However, it's up to you to accept them, which is not always, we always tend to kind of think we're creating our own path, and it has to be come from our own power of our own mind, and that can block the energy from being able to accept some of the gifts that the universe gives and presents to us. However, if we can allow ourselves to take those gifts, those breadcrumbs that the universe leaves in our path, it can actually exceed our expectations for joy. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Excellent. Something challenging or blocking is the Star card, which is in the Major Arcana, and it's card number 17. Now, card number 16, the card right before the Star card, is the Tower, which talks about a lot of change. So this is card number 17, which means that it's time to take a calm after the storm. Sometimes when things have been kind of bumpy, kind of rough, kind of changes, even good changes can still be changes that upset our own ability to embrace the those future joys. And when we have that, we sometimes kind of stay in a hyper-vigilant situation, which makes it that much more challenging to see those gifts that the universe brings. Please take this card as validation that this is the time to kind of take a deep breath, begin to believe in magic and miracles, and allow those dreams to come up to that surface without limitations, because nothing is off limits at this point and everything is possible. However, if you're thinking that it's going to be, I got to be prepared for the next shoe to drop, then it closes us off from that guidance. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I kind of stopped doing that because I was so, like, intense. Like, when's everything going to happen? I had to step back.
It's understandable. You know, we want to just kind of push those things forward. But almost like in Tai Chi, I had a guest on yesterday talking about Tai Chi. When you push force against force, it actually blocks movement. And so it's best when we can kind of receive it. But that's easier said than done. So often when we see a closed door, we try to figure out what we can do to get that door open, whether it be prying the door, knocking it down, jimmying the lock. However, I look at it from an energy perspective. And so when I see a closed door, that's the universe saying, go to a different door. Go through the doors that work. But that takes the ability to kind of just release the process of trying to push open a door. And that's the hardest part, because if I'm pushing against the wall, trying to get it to move, it's not moving. But my brain thinks it's moving because my arm's getting all tense and everything. Something that might help is the advice card. And the advice card that came up is the Five of Cups. Now, in this card, it talks about that opportunity, that joy, that open door is really close, because in this card, you see a man and he's got these two upright cups right behind him. However, his whole demeanor and attention is focused on what's in front of him, which are three spilled cups of wine or grape juice. And so for him to embrace that opportunity, it requires making a conscious turn away from perhaps perceived failures, even if they weren't, perceived mistakes, even if they weren't, disappointments, loss, sadness. If the universe put those two cups in front of those three cups, you still wouldn't see it. Rather, allow yourself the ability to bless all the experiences that have happened to date, because that's part of how, you know, we are a product of our experiences, and no experience is ever wasted. However, once you bless that, give yourself the permission to physically and mentally turn away, perhaps ritualistically bless, writing down on a sheet of paper some of those disappointments and sadness and everything, expectations that weren't met, and then just bless it with love, burn it immediately, and then just see how your body feels afterward. But from my perspective, looking at this reading, Kathy, this is the start of a neat chapter. It just is kind of a thing of, instead of kind of pushing to try to get that door open, instead step back, release what you may be carrying around with you that you don't need to anymore, and then just turn and enjoy that journey and just look for the open doors, that the doors that are moving and are open. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. Thank you so much.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Will you please give us an update and let us know how things go? Yeah, just be sure, if you do burn something, just make sure to do it by an open window, because you don't want to burn down the house. It stinks up the whole house. It's not a very pleasant thing. But this is also one other point I wanted to say, is that this is also a time of really embracing unconditional self-acceptance. You know, because this is your journey, it's going to look like that of nobody else on this planet. And so you determine where things go, how things are, your path as conventional or as unconventional as you possibly want it to be. And as I said, in that Five of Cups, some people look at that card and they say, oh, it's a sad card. But that's only if you're looking at the three spilled cups of wine or grape juice. Instead, it's also that positive reading in terms of embracing the joy that's right there behind you.
Thank you.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I hope this has been helpful. And it has been so lovely talking with you today.
You too. You have a wonderful day.
Thank you so much. Thanks so much for calling. Well, it looks like we are just going to take a quick break. And then when we get back, we've got more readings to do. You are listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'll be right back.
Are you searching? Looking for a sign? A message you need to hear? From the great unknown? From the most mysterious place that is the most familiar to your soul and the depths of who you are? The universe put someone here to talk to, someone God gave a blessing to that you may find insight with. TheAngelLady.net. 1-800-323-1790.
Did you know that all of the shows on the Transformation Radio Network are available as podcasts to stream or download?
Really?
Check us out. Go to transformationradio.fm. We have business shows, spiritual shows, energy healing shows, and pretty much everything in between. Something for everyone, guaranteed to inspire, educate, and transform. We are transforming the world, one listener at a time.
Are you feeling stagnant or blocked in your love life, career, health, or finances? Experiencing difficulty focusing or setting and achieving goals? Tune in to Spiritual Diagnostics Radio with psychic visionary healers Carol Dorian and Suzanne Evans. Discover the cause and effect of unwanted patterns in life. Tune in every Tuesday at 12 p.m. Pacific on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit spiritualdeed.com.
Interested in deepening your spiritual practice? The School for Esoteric Studies offers online training to spiritual seekers from all paths of life and individual coaching. Our courses synthesize Eastern and Western spiritual traditions based on meditation, study, and service applied to everyday life. To learn more about our courses and services, please visit www.esotericstudies.net.
Discover the healing medicine from the giant monkey tree frog, Cambo. Cambo practitioner Ginny Rutherford and professional psychic Todd Rolson have come together for lively discussions of alternative healing medicines from the Amazon. Ginny and Todd bring you Cambo Talk Radio. Tune in each Monday at 1 p.m. Pacific to hear from guests all over the world with real life stories and the medicinal benefits of Cambo. For more information, visit CamboKiss.com.
Tune in to the Psychic Professor's Show, The Voices of Spirit Radio, with international medium and spirit artist Dr. Susan Barnes on Transformation Talk Radio. Featuring a variety of spiritual topics such as psychic art, spiritualism, EVP, psychic development, and mediumship. This hit call-in show provides listeners with breakthrough wisdom to enliven and enlighten their lives. Visit spiritartgallery.net for show days and times.
Just on the night, like the 4th of July. Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. If you'd like to learn more about me, book a reading over phone or Skype worldwide, or for an event nationwide, you can go to my website, elitetarot.com, or mainstreammetaphysicsradio.com. We are rescheduling the show on pendulums that was originally slated for this week to next week due to some phone issues. So please come back next week to hear more about pendulums. And we are just doing calls for the rest of the show. So let's take the next caller, which is Monica. Monica, welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Hi. Boy, I'm so glad that I got through. This is exciting.
Me too. I'm happy you got through as well. Is there anything you have a question about, would like guidance on, or just a general reading?
Well, I'm having some issues in my chest area, and I know that all issues that manifest physically come from energetic issues that we're not paying attention to, and so then they come into the physical. So I'm wondering if you could do a reading and see what my guides have been trying to tell me that I haven't been paying attention to.
Well, absolutely. While you've been talking, I've been just shuffling and pulling three cards on your behalf. I do need to say, though, I am not a doctor. And so I'm pointing up to the sky saying a lot of that is above my pay grade, but I can definitely look at things. I can definitely look at things from just from the universe perspective that might be able to kind of shed some light. The first card that came up was the Ace of Wands. So it's interesting because we have another Ace card to start it off, which is really interesting because in this card, you've got the universe presenting rather than a cup as in Kathy's call in the last section, but this time a wand. And wands talk a lot about creativity and feeling inspired. And so often, particularly when we're worrying about health concerns and everything, we tend to kind of put off our own things about what inspires us. And it, yet again, similar to Kathy's call, this is not coming from within. And so thinking more does not necessarily yield the result that you're wanting, because it may be something that is being presented from the universe in the form of, you know, somebody saying, you know, hey, Monica, have you ever thought about doing this? Or, you know, you pass this sign as you drive home every day, and it's like, I wonder if you've never thought about doing belly dancing, you know? It's that sort of a thing. And the universe can present that, but it's up to you to accept it. Does that make sense?
Yes, yes.
Well, you know, you have a really interesting reading here, because I just turned over the card that's challenging or blocking you, and it's the Ace of Swords. So we have two aces crossed with each other. And again, we've got, rather this time, not a cup or a wand, but a sword being presented by the universe. And swords are all about taking action. And I think that perhaps there's been a feeling of hesitancy about taking action. And this is a card saying, just take action. In some ways, it almost doesn't matter what action you take, just to take the belly dancing class, you know, that you've been thinking about, you know, just to get back into the mode of your strength, rather than seeing yourself as sort of a beholden to something greater than you, that is more powerful than you, in terms of an illness or worries or anything like that. And so it's really about taking those steps for action. Does that resonate?
Yeah.
You know, the advice card is the Emperor. Now, the Emperor is different from a king, because you're born into being an emperor. You don't get promoted, you know, hey, Monica, you're doing a great job. We're making you emperor. And so that means that early on in life, you probably had to kind of take more of a serious path, perhaps due to situations going on with family situations, but where that meant that that energy has always served you well, and it will continue to do so. But there's a bit of a weightiness and a seriousness to you, which is where it comes from, which then makes it more challenging to embrace joy. and embrace kind of honoring yourself with frivolous things. I mentioned the belly dancing again, you know, simple things, painting, playing with the dog, all of that you probably kind of put off to the side in deference to other people's needs. This is a card saying, no, honor yourself, but give yourself that permission to enjoy those joys and then see how the body feels. Again, it's, you know, it's not, I don't approach things from an actual health perspective, but this may help complement whatever else that you're doing, but just have some fun, but make the decisions to do that despite the, whatever your brain is saying.
Yeah, makes sense.
I hope that's been helpful for you. Please call us back and give us an update, okay?
Okay, I certainly will. Thank you for the time.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thank you so much for calling. Well, we are going to take our next call, and we've got a little bit of a tornado going on, so hopefully we'll be able to make it through the hour.
Wait, like right now, like you can see it outside your window?
I can't see it outside the window, but all of a sudden I'm getting all these alerts and it's sounding pretty ominous. So.
And here we are complaining about like a quarter of an inch of rain in the Seattle area again, in like a third day in a row or whatever, and you have a tornado in your backyard. That's good. Good to know.
It's just interesting.
That's awesome. It's
when it rains, it funnels.
No pun intended.
Exactly. Well, let's take on the next call. The next call is Patrick. Patrick, welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Hi.
So nice to hear your voice. Is there anything you have a question about, would like guidance on, or just a general reading?
I think just a general reading.
You got it. So what I'm doing is I've just been shuffling the cards and for Patrick, and I'm just cutting the deck. And I'm fanning the cards face down in front of me, and I'm just choosing three cards. I don't know if you can hear the winds howling right now. All right, Patrick. So the first card that came up is the Six of Pentacles. Now, there you have got a heart as big as Texas. And so it's always so important to make sure that people are being taken care of, that you're honoring other people. In this card, you see a person who's helping those in need and really being considerate and wanting to give. And in fact, it's very challenging when you're seeing people who are struggling or are needing assistance. And this gives you a good feeling to be able to help that person. Does that make sense?
Yeah, you're saying that, am I the person who's helping someone?
Yes, in the sense that that's something that's very important for you. The key about this card, however, is that for every person that you help, there's nothing wrong with doing it. We should be doing it, is that there's always going to be more. So whether it's even family members kind of asking for assistance and everything like that, there may not be an end to the need, what is critical is making sure that you make sure you're giving yourself balance and kind of that you're honoring yourself rather than just being so responsive to other people and other situations that it actually drains you, where then you can almost feel resentful about something that you actually like to do. Does that make sense?
Yes, it makes sense.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting because the cross card, something challenging or blocking, it's one of my scary looking cards, but it's not a scary looking card. It's not a scary card. And it's the devil. Now, the devil card has nothing to do with an actual devil, but a devil card is all about compromise. And what you can, and you can actually see the Six of Pentacles with the Devil card, they're very similar in structure. But basically, when the Devil card comes up, it talks about a willful compromise. So, for example, taking a job for money, but not one that utilizes all of your gifts. Sometimes it's the right thing to do. There's nothing wrong about doing that. But then if you go into that situation, know that you don't, to get resentful for the fact that you're not being given a chance to really flex your muscles and do your gifts is wrong because it was a compromise to begin with. Mm-hmm. At the same time, when you feel that, you know, it's like, oh my gosh, I'm in this situation and I really need to be more of myself, know that you have power. And so it's really deciding, recognizing, are you in a willful compromise? Have you entered into a compromise? And to know that you have the power to either stay in that compromise and get the goodies from it, which sometimes are extremely valid. Just like mm-hmm. that, you know, if things are tight and we need to take this job and we need that money, but know that it's a compromise and it should not be considered a long-term solution either. Or you need to make sure that you are honoring yourself and taking care of the things to be sure that you are working from unconditional self-acceptance exterior to the compromise. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I'll have to ponder it for a while, I think.
Yeah, you know, and what's interesting about this card is that the advice card was the Hanged Man. And this is also not a scary card at all, but it looks a little scary because you've got a person hanging upside down. But this is
a devil and a hangman. That's pretty ominous,
they're both major arcana cards, which rather than what they are, the fact that they're both major arcana cards really talks to this being a time of reevaluating, taking this time to say, what is it that I want in this next chapter? Who am I in this next chapter of my journey? As opposed to what specifically you do. And that's the difference between major cards and minor cards. And so with the Hanged Man, this is a slow moving thing because the Hanged Man is saying, find the peace in the stillness. Don't feel the need to actually take action right away, but rather allow inspiration to organically come to the surface rather than force it. Recognizing that if you are compromising your authenticity in some way, ask yourself, is this what is the right thing for right now? Or is this the time that I want to kind of take off the chains from the devil and really become more who I am, knowing that I won't get the goodies that being in that compromise offers me. But no action is required or recommended at this time, because if we force it, then we tend to kind of get a little bit astray instead of just allowing things to happen naturally. That's why this can be a frustrating card, because it's saying just take some time and just really allow things to happen organically.
I'm very okay with that. It's just what I wanted to hear.
Oh, excellent. Love hearing that. Let us know how it goes. And I hope that's been helpful for you.
Yes, thank you. I appreciate it.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you so much for calling. Well, we're going to take our last break. When we come back, got more readings to do. You're listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. We'll be right back.
Diane Robbins, published author and channel, connects our hearts to the hearts of beings in advanced civilizations as she taps into the cosmos. We are living in important times now as we merge our consciousness with these of other realms and raise our vibration and awaken to who we are and why we are here. Learn to live in unconditional love. Visit DianeRobbins.com today and immerse yourself in the many books, newsletters, and channeling Diane has to offer.
To see your life from an angel's perspective, book a personal consultation with Claire Candy Huff, angelic walk-in angel Ariel at Angel Healing House. Candy provides intuitive counseling, Reiki, and angel readings in person in Los Angeles or nationally and internationally via phone or Skype. She will channel the practical tools you need to transform your life. Call now, 831-277-3716, or visit angelhealinghouse.com.
Be you plus live your purpose equals joy.
That's the motto of Unstuck Joy with Vicki Todd. Vicki believes you were born with gifts that are meant to make the world brighter. Each show will feature an art visioning journal prompt to help you create your way to soul clarity. If you're ready to get unstuck and create more joy, this show is for you. Tune in every month on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit VickiWorldArt.com.
Are you traveling most of your day? Do you want to take Transformation Talk Radio with you anywhere you go? Well, guess what? There's an app for that. Just go to the App Store on your Apple device or the Google Play Store on your Android and search Transformation Talk Radio. Catch all of our live shows no matter where you are. Thanks for listening.
Are you ready to thread your life with intuition? Intuit Apparel can help you do just that. This is not just about a piece of clothing. This is about a movement, an awakening, and staying centered in life. Your life. Intuitive and host of the radio show Get Into It, Lynn Brown, was given this image with the intention of a clothing line designed to represent the essence of life itself. Visit intuitapparel.com now and wear your intuition with pride.
Get ready to experience Truth Talk Radio with host Deb Acker. Tune in to Truth Talk Radio each Wednesday at 3 p.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com to illuminate the truth in your daily life as you experience life, love, and abundance from a whole new perspective. This hit show will leave you feeling lighter and bring you into a place of infinite possibilities every day in every way. Visit TruthTalkRadioShow.com for upcoming transformative topics and guests.
Good morning, starshine. The earth says hello. You twinkle above us, twinkle below.
Welcome back to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. I'm Eve, the MBA psychic from Elite Tarot. If you'd like to hear more of me, I'm going to be actually interviewed this Saturday on Ken's Psychic Tapestry Show, my guest supposedly for today, but unfortunately we had to move it over to next week. It's going to be this Saturday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern. I'll be talking to him and doing readings. You can get all the details at psychictapestry.com. But today we've got one more reading to do, so Gary, welcome to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio.
Thank you.
Is there anything you have a question about, like guidance on, or just a general reading?
Yeah, guidance. Incredible things happen, as you know. I feel that the Holy Spirit moved on me in a church setting where I went upon suggestion of another party to get some holy water that you drink that directs itself to inward conditions. And not having drank any, she returned something to me, and I feel that I was being bilked in that situation now. Because later I went into a gift shop and I was inwardly just prompted to ask for something that was sanctified. And I got this scarf. It was blessed to resting on the relic of St. Luke.
I don't mean to cut you off because I want to hear everything except that we're kind of coming to the end of the show and I don't want to shortchange your reading. I'm going to just go and finish the reading just so that I don't want to cut you off on your reading here. But I appreciate everything that's going on right now. I always say that you're best served when you allow yourself to kind of be tossed like a paper in the wind by the universe. and getting out of our own head. And so it sounds like that's exactly what you're doing, which is always very positive. And that is actually reflected by the first card that came up, which is the Page of Swords. Now, this is my favorite card in the tarot because it is my card for the inner child. I always say that you are best served when you let your inner child be your GPS, but you have the keys to the car, Gary. And so, but when you allow that same adventure of spirit that you had when you were 8, when you were 10 years old, before you had engaged in experiences of life and challenges and all of that, that that same motivation energy will still kind of project you now today. And so for this card to come up in this position really validates the fact that you are letting universal energy kind of work with you and following that adventurous part of your journey. So that is all fantastic. Does that make sense?
It does. I was an orphan as a boy.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. And so yeah. As an orphan, there was also probably that ability where you had to kind of make allowances for that and really kind of allow your mind to kind of go into places of the different paths that you can take. And so that's where some of those tools were developed. Even if they were done under more hardship sort of conditions, those tools are still with you today. Does that make sense?
Sure.
And something challenging or blocking you is the Ace of Swords. And so, again, similar to, I guess, Monica's call, aces are about beginnings, but swords are about action. And this is a card saying about taking action that the universe is kind of presenting to you. And so sometimes we kind of get a little bit hung up on where we feel we should be going versus where the universe is directing us. And even though it sounds like you are definitely in tune to that process, as I just need to honor this card with the sense of not being hesitant to block, not being hesitant to take the action that you need to take to ensure that you're on your path of adventure and joy in this new chapter of your journey. And to kind of highlight that even more, the advice card is the Star card. And as I said before, it's interesting that this card came up again because it really does talk to the fact that things have been, there've been a lot of changes in your life. There's been a lot of turmoil. Again, even some positives can still be turmoil to the system. And this is a card about embracing that calm after the storm, which means allowing yourself to look at yourself with unconditional self-acceptance, but also to allow yourself to have those dreams and beliefs and magic and believe in all of the majesty of the universe that it can provide to you, and not to feel as if you have to be so waiting for another shoe to drop, because it's in that unconscious holding of energy where we block that energy from being able to take the action that we need to take. I definitely see in terms of looking at this that you're on your way and in doing that, because every time that you have deviated from honoring, having your inner child be that GPS, that's where perhaps things went off your course. And now that you've got this in the driver's seat and he's right there, he can't reach the steering wheel and he's probably not old enough to drive. So you have the keys and you're the one driving the car, but he's that GPS. And I'm really excited about this chapter of your journey. And Gary, I am so sorry, but we are going to be closing down the show, but I really appreciate that you called, and please keep us updated. So thank you so much, Gary, for calling. And I can't believe the show it just swung by so fast. I want to thank everyone for tuning in to today's show of Mainstream Metaphysics Radio. Benny, thank you so much for running this show, and thank you to everyone for tuning in. Just as a reminder, if you want to hear me, I'll be on this Saturday's Psychic Tapestry show, which you can find on all the details on psychictapestry.com, being interviewed by my guest for today, who is not here today, but he'll be here next week, Ken Kessler of Psychic Tapestry, and I'll be on this Saturday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern. If you'd like more information about me, you can always go to my website, schedule a session. A usual reading takes about 60, 75 minutes and includes a summary of everything we talk about, photo of the final tarot card layout, and a recording of the entire session. Wow, I'm so honored and I'm so grateful to be able to do this show each week. Next week, on next week's show, we are going to be talking pendulums with Ken Kessler. Please join me next week, but every Thursday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern. With peace and love and gratitude, see you back here next time.
You've been listening to Mainstream Metaphysics Radio with your host, Eve. Join us Thursdays at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com to harness the power of the universe for optimal success and happiness, as Eve continues to take metaphysics mainstream. Until then, learn more about Eve and Elite Tarot at EliteTarot.com. That's EliteTarot.com. See you next week.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.